My ministry will redouble our efforts to engage our youth at this important stage of their lives. We will do more to support the aspiration of all youths. We will equip them with vital life skills and help them discover their calling and passion. We will enable them to create their own ground-up initiatives, go for their dreams in diverse areas, and lead fulfilling lives. To realize these goals, we will increase our investments in our youths. One specific area we are looking at is to enhance and widen the spaces for youth participation and involvement. So we will be embarking on a review of SCAPE to look at the use of space, the tenant mix, and to see how we can have new programs that would be more appealing and more relevant to youth, for example, in areas like music and media. So this is our plan for SCAPE version 2.0. Beyond having SCAPE in the city centre, we are also planning more youth spaces and programs in other parts of the island so that we can reach out to more youths nationwide. One important partner is Outward Bound Singapore, OBS. Currently, OBS provides customized outdoor experiential learning programs for many school students. And I've received consistently good feedback about the OBS trainers and their programs. Many young people who have gone through OBS would share that it is a transformational, life-changing experience, and perhaps members yourselves have experienced it. So we plan to scale up the OBS programs and enable more young people to benefit from them. To do all this, we need to restructure and to strengthen the National Youth Council. We want the National Youth Council to be a national body overseeing youth affairs. In all that we do, we will continue to provide fair access to opportunities for our youth, regardless of their backgrounds. This is something many members have emphasized in the points they raised during the debate about social mobility. I understand the concerns. It's something that weighs heavily on our minds too. In Singapore, no one should be deprived of the chance to broaden his horizon or develop a talent because of his family circumstances or social background. And so MCCY and MOE have been working together to offer more youth programs, be it in arts, sports, or other areas, both within and outside schools. In sports, for example, we have put in place programs to reach out to youths from lower income or disadvantaged homes. Some of them have not had much exposure in sports, but they show tremendous promise. And importantly, there will be pathways for them to develop further, for example, through the Singapore Sports School. Likewise, in arts and culture, we've made museum entry free for Singaporeans, and we are continuing to bring arts programs closer to the community, especially to our youths. We want them to experience the arts at an early age, enrich their lives, and also have access to multiple pathways to develop their talents further. So I want to assure all members that our offerings will continue to be inclusive and accessible so that all Singaporeans can participate and benefit.